Hi dolls, in today's video I'll show you how I restored this Ponytail Swirl Barbie. Ponytail Swirl Barbies were introduced in 1964, right after the bubble cut, and were replaced 1 year later by the American Girl Barbie, effectively making this the last line of Barbies that represented 50s glamour, making her very valuable to collectors. Some of her paint is missing, she has scratches on her legs, and her hair is a mess. I start by giving her hair and body a bath with dishwashing soap. Then I scrub gently with a toothbrush to remove dust and grime. You can tell this doll has been well loved, as her hair is very frizzy, so I condition it with some fabric softener. And I brush it in. Before anyone comes for me, I know the bald patch was intentional, as to not add too much bulk, but as she will be part of my collection, I decided to give her some hair anyway. In order to keep it manageable and prevent it from becoming bulky, I am using nylon hair, which is considerably thinner than regular doll hair, and it will not add tons of volume. Then I glue the hair in place and tame it with boiling water, so I can move on to the next step. For the haircut, I simply followed where the original hair ended and cut the new hair accordingly. Cover her hair in aluminium foil and use my rollers to curl the hair upwards. I burned it once more with boiling water. Then removed the rollers and covered everything with a wig cap, so that it would dry without losing its shape. To address the scratches on her legs, I simply sanded everything down with a soft sandpaper block. Now, moving on to the face. Most vintage Barbies will have faces that darken with time. And while it is possible to lighten it with peroxide, I just didn't want to take any chances. But I will be adding some color back into her face with soft pastels. I add a mixture of pink, orange, and yellow to counteract the green hue. Then, I blush the apples of her cheeks. I press the pigment in using a soft eyeshadow packing brush with no sealant. this will give her a very subtle wash of color. Time to deal with her face paint. I used acrylic paints with no primer, as I wanted the process to be reversible if ever I decided to go back and fix something. As her lip color has faded to white, which is common for dolls, so I took the creative liberty of imagining she once had red lips. I used watered-down acrylic and painted several coats until I reached the desired level of intensity. After the paint job, I sealed everything with a semi-glossy varnish. Now prepping her finger and toenails for a coat of MSC so that I can paint her nails. Moving on to the hair. I first brush through the curls, and it may seem like too much hair, but I promise it's not. I sectioned her bangs, and tied her hair in a ponytail in the back. I used hair mousse to keep everything sleek, then gave her the signature swirl in the front. Then I tied everything back and hid the elastic band with some hair. Then I swirled the ends around my finger and set in place with hairspray. For the outfit, I used a replica of her original bathing suit and shoes, as well as plastic pearl earrings to remove the danger of green ear. that brings us to the end of this process. If you enjoyed my video, please consider subscribing and following me on Instagram at DoeDeerWonderland. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.